Hey, I just got a brand new pair of Head Edge ski boots, and I'm about to throw them into my oven and thermoform them myself. I've never done this before, but if you're watching this, it must have worked. So let's go together. This particular Head boot and a bunch of their other models have a liner that is thermoformable. It also has a shell that's thermoformable. And with this particular model and with Head, as opposed to some of the other manufacturers out there, you can actually form the liner inside the shell at the same time. So I don't have to go through the process of forming the liner separately. I can bake the entire thing and then just slide my foot straight in. I wouldn't recommend trying that with a bunch of other manufacturers because you might damage the liner. So just pay attention to your manufacturer's instructions about whether or not the shell has to be formed separately. Head says their boots are supposed to be heated to 100 degrees Celsius, which is 212 Fahrenheit, the boiling point of water. So I'm going to set my oven down right around the temperature I want them to get to so I can bake them in there for the appropriate time. My particular oven will hold them both at the same time, but not upright. So I'm going to throw them on a cookie sheet. So while the oven's heating up, I bought the Head Edge Lite 285 length boots with the 100 stiffness. I wear a size 12 shoe. If you look on the shoe size chart that tells you what size boot to buy for your given US shoe size, it would leave me to buy a much larger boot than I got. I bought the 285 and it fits perfect. So my foot barely hangs over an 11 inch piece of paper. The 11-inch piece of paper is 279 millimeters, so my foot is about 285 millimeters in length. Every time I've gone into a ski shop and told them I had a size 12 shoe, I got the wrong size ski boot. They recommend that you pile a bunch of frozen peas and other stuff onto your boot in order to reduce the temperature of the plastic after it's molded to your foot. I am going to quench it instead. So I'm filling the water in the bathtub up to the point where it will just reach the split in the boot. I don't really want to get the liner wet. I could dry it out if I need to, but I'm going to have the water come up just to that level and then let that cool the boot off when I'm finished. So let's go. So I think that does it. When I step in after I'm done, I'm going to make sure the water surrounds the sides but doesn't come up over the toe. I spun all the buckles away so that I don't have to fiddle with them when they're boiling water temperature. And I should be able to just twist them and lock them into place after I get my feet in. Okay, the oven's hot. I got off my infrared thermometer. It says I'm running about 270 degrees inside there, so it's time to throw in the boots. Okay, here goes 400 bucks into the fire. Head says we're supposed to leave it in and get it to 212 degrees for 10 minutes. Okay, they've been in 10 minutes, but they're running about 180. Ooh, 200 on the cuff, and about 170 down there. This is where the instructions aren't totally clear because I'm not positive if I'm supposed to keep them in there for just 10 minutes or whether I'm supposed to let them reach 212 across the boot. But that's what I'm going to do because I want it to mold. Okay, now they've been in for almost 15 minutes, but the temperature is pretty inconsistent. Check this out. On the heel, 200. On the body, 187. On the cuff, where it ought to be. On the toe of the other boot, 180. Okay, that's about 17 minutes. I don't want to leave them in any longer because I can always heat them up again if this doesn't work, and I think the temperatures are just about right. So let's go. All right, I got my gloves. Buckles are hot. I'm gonna do both at one time. Got my nice thin ski socks. Let's go. So I'm going to maintain a neutral stance. Even though they say you shouldn't tighten them very much, I want to make some more room because I have a wide foot. So I'm going to push it a little farther. And I'm going to stand like this for 10 minutes. Standing like this is very boring, so I decided to play with the thermometer. As it sits now after that process, it's dropped to about 143, 125. So it's cooled off really quickly. Hope that was enough. Well, after the first try, I wasn't happy with the way they fit. I have a really wide foot and I need a little bit more expansion, I think. So luckily, I think I can just keep trying again. I went and put some closed cell foam inside my sock in order to generate a little bit more width because I feel pressure points along the sides of my foot and especially right here on top when I was in the process of standing in them for 10 minutes. Then I heated the oven up to 300 degrees, turned it off, and then put the boots back inside for 10 minutes. So it's time to take them out and try again. Okay, the boots are reading about 190. Hotter than that on the cuff. Just want to get that to about 210. Okay, here we go again. Okay, my toes are hot and crushed by all that foam I shoved into my socks, so I gotta get out of here. Right now, boots are still reading 115 degrees or so, and I'm about to quench them in the tub. Okay, here we go. I hope I got this depth right. So the part of the boot that's under the water dropped to 85 degrees, 86. The part that's out is still running about 110. Since the only part I'm trying to form is the front and the sides, I think this does it. Okay, after it's all done, there's no harm to the exterior, no weird melted spots or anything like that. Even the sticker came through okay. So it appears that it didn't cause them any harm. So let's try them on. Well, as I mentioned, these fit great right out of the box, but I can absolutely feel the width inside my right foot, which had a few hot spots, and that closed cell foam that I put inside my socks definitely widened it up compared to where it was in the first heat forming. So overall, I think it feels terrific. They've never been skied in, obviously, so after a day on the slopes, I think it'll loosen up the liners even a little bit more, and I'm hoping that this will be the most coupled my foot has ever been to a boot. All right, thanks for watching.